हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम बैक टू माय यूट्यूब चैनल। दिस इज लेक्चर 6 ऑफ अ जियो टेक्निकल इंजीनियरिंग प्लेलिस्ट। ओके, इन दिस लेक्चर वी आर गोइंग टू सी सम मोर इम्पॉर्टेंट टॉपिक्स ऑफ जियो टेक्निकल इंजीनियरिंग। वी हैव ऑलरेडी कवर्ड द लेक्चर 1 टू लेक्चर 5। ओके, सो दीज आर द टॉपिक ऑफ लेक्चर 1 टू लेक्चर 5। यू कैन सी द टॉपिक्स हेयर एंड यू कैन कवर दीज लेक्चर फ्रॉम द जियो टेक्निकल इंजीनियरिंग प्लेलिस्ट। ओके, सो दीज आर द टॉपिक्स ऑफ your lectures. Okay, so in today's video we are going to cover the lecture 6, and in the upcoming lectures we will see lecture 7 to lecture 10. Okay, so if you haven't subscribed the channel, then please do subscribe it so that you will get the notification about the upcoming lectures. Okay, now we will focus on our lecture 6. Okay, in this lecture we will cover some more important topic. First we will start with the shear strength topic. Okay, so for the shear strength, solid drive their stern mainly due to interlocking between the particles, frictional resistance and intermolecular attraction force. Okay, so first, for the coarse grain soil like sand and gravel, it is frictional soil and cohesion less soil. Okay, next is C5 soil. Okay, the example of C5 soil is silty soil, means it is frictional and cohesive also. Okay, next is pure cohesive soil. Pure cohesive soil example is clay. So for the pure cohesive soil, it is frictionless soil or cohesive soil. Okay, so if you understand the difference between the coarse grain soil, C5 soil, okay, or your pure cohesive soil, this I am explaining this to you because this is important for determining the shear strength of a soil. Okay, now we will move ahead and see the shear strength in detail. Okay, this is the graph between the shear stress and normal stress. Okay, shear stress is denoted by your tau and normal stress will be denoted by sigma n. So from this graph you can determine the shear strength. Tau f is equals to c plus sigma n tan phi. What is c here? C is the cohesion. Okay, cohesion plus your normal stress multiplied by tan phi. Okay, so this is the equation by the Mohr-Coulomb theory. This is the equation to determine your shear strength. This is the main equation to determine your shear strength. According to modified Mohr-Coulomb theory, your shear strength will be equals to C dash plus sigma n bar tan phi dash. Okay, so what is C dash and phi dash? C dash and phi dash are called effective shear strength parameter. Okay, sigma n bar will be equals to your effective normal stress. This is normal stress sigma n, and this one will be your effective normal stress. Okay, so according to modified Coulomb theory, okay, Mohr-Coulomb theory, this will be your equation, and by Mohr-Coulomb theory this will be your equation to determine the shear strength. Okay, so for the case 1, that is in case of cohesive soil, okay, I have already explained that the cohesive soil are frictionless soil. Okay, so for the frictionless soil, phi will be equals to 0. So if you put the value of 0 in this equation, okay, in this equation, if you put the value of phi is equals to 0, then you will get the shear strength as C dash, means the your shear strength in case of cohesive soil will be equal to your cohesion value. So case second, in case of frictional soil. So in case of frictional soil means your cohesion value is 0. So if you put the cohesion value 0 here, then you will get the shear strength as a effective normal stress multiplied by your tan phi. Okay, so this in this equation you have to write the value of phi and C in case of cohesive and frictional soil. Okay, now we will move to our next topic, coefficient of earth pressure. Okay, so coefficient of earth pressure at rest means K0. Okay, it is denoted by K0 or K0, that is equals to mu upon 1 minus mu, or K0 of OCC will be equals to K0 of NCC under root of OCR, over consolidation ratio. Okay, we have already covered what is over consolidation ratio, so you can cover this from the previous lectures. Okay, so K0 will be equals to 1 minus sin phi. Okay, these are the three formula to determine the coefficient of earth pressure at rest. Now second one is active earth pressure coefficient, Ka. Okay, means away from the backfill. So your Ka will be equals to 1 minus sin phi upon 1 plus sin phi, or it is equals to 10 square 45 minus phi by 2. Okay, this is important formula. Remember this, that you have to determine the coefficient of earth pressure ओके, एक्टिव अर्थ प्रेशर एंड पैसिव अर्थ प्रेशर. नाउ यू विल सी दी पैसिव अर्थ प्रेशर कॉफिशेंट के पी. सो पैसिव अर्थ प्रेशर कॉफिशेंट के पी मीन्स टूवर्ड दी बैकफिल. ओके, सो योर के पी विल बी इक्वल्स टू 1 प्लस साइन फाइव अपॉन 1 माइनस साइन फाइव इज इक्वल टू 10 स्क्वायर 45 प्लस 5 बाई 2. ओके, 45 प्लस 5 बाई 2. This is the formula to determine the active earth pressure coefficient in case of inclination. Okay, where phi is equals to the angle of internal friction and beta is equals to the inclination of slope with the ground. Okay, so this is the difference between phi and beta. Next, you can see here that relation between the active and passive earth pressure coefficient is your active earth pressure coefficient is equals to 1 upon your passive earth pressure coefficient. So if you find the value of one, you can simply find the value of other with this formula. Okay, next topic is equation of stress path. Okay, so this is the main equation of stress path. P sine phi dash plus C dash cos phi dash is equals to Q. Okay, means P sine phi C cos phi is equals to Q. Okay, dash, or you can write that sigma 1 bar plus sigma 3 bar by 2 sin phi dash, okay, plus C dash cos phi dash is equals to sigma 1 bar minus sigma 3 bar by 2. When you compare that two equation, you can easily get that the value of your P, or P is your center. Okay, so the value of P will be equals to sigma 1 bar plus sigma 3 bar by 2, means this is your center, and the value of Q will be equals to sigma 1 bar minus sigma 3 bar by 2, it is your radius. Okay, so on comparing the two equation, you get the value of center and radius. Your sigma 1 bar will be equals to your sigma 3 bar, 10 square 45 plus 5 by 2 plus 2 c tan phi 45 plus 5 by 2. Okay, this is another important equation, or you can write it as a sigma 1 bar will be equals to sigma 3 bar kp. This part is your kp, means passive earth pressure coefficient. Okay, so your kp plus 2 c under root of kp. This is also an important equation. Here you can see that alpha is equals to 45 plus 5 by 2 for the cohesionless soil. Okay, and alpha will be equals to 45 for the cohesive soil, because in the cohesive soil phi value is equals to 0. Okay, so alpha will be equals to 45 for the cohesive soil and 45 plus 5 by 2 for the cohesionless soil or the frictional soil. Okay, next is your sigma 3 bar is your minor principal stress, sigma 1 bar will be equals to your major principal stress, okay, and sigma 1 bar will be equals to your minor principal stress plus the deviator stress at failure. This is important. How you can find the value of major principal stress? By adding the minor principal stress to deviator stress at failure. This is deviator stress but at a failure. Okay, so our next important topic is Skempton's pore pressure parameters. Okay, so at the cell pressure stage, P will be equals to your change in the pore pressure upon change in the confining pressure. Okay, so P will be equals to change in the pore pressure at the cell pressure stage upon the change in the confining pressure. Okay, change in confining pressure. Next is at the shearing stage, that means A bar will be equals to change in pore pressure at a deviator stress upon change in the deviatoric stress. Your A bar will be equals to change in the pore water pressure at a deviator stress, okay, upon the change in the deviatoric stress. A bar is equals to A multiplied by B. Okay, and your change in the pore pressure is equals to pore water pressure is equals to change in the pore water pressure at the cell pressure stage plus change in the pore water pressure at the shearing or deviator stress stage. Okay, so if you write the value of change in UC, okay, change in pore water pressure at the cell pressure stage and change in pore water pressure at the shearing stage here, okay, so this will be the equation for your total pore pressure. Okay, I hope you have understood the pore pressure, Skempton's pore pressure parameters. Now we will move ahead. Now we will see what is consolidation drain test, consolidation undrained test and unconsolidated undrained test. Okay, so first we will see what is consolidation drain test. It is also called CD test or slow test. So in this first stage means at the cell pressure stage, drainage is allowed. Okay, in this type of test, at the first stage means at the cell pressure stage, drainage is allowed. That means your pore water pressure at the cell pressure stage will be equals to zero. When drainage is allowed, no pore water pressure develops. Okay, that means simply your pore water pressure at the cell pressure stage will be equals to zero. At the second stage means at deviator stress, okay, your drainage is also allowed. That means your pore water pressure at the deviator stress will also be zero. Hence your sigma 1 bar will be equals to your sigma 1 and your sigma 3 bar will be equals to your sigma 3. Okay, your effective stress will be equals to your sigma 1 and your effective minor principal stress will be equals to your sigma 3. Now we will see the second type of test, the consolidation undrained test. Okay, so in this test, it is also known as CU test. This is CD test and this is CU test. So in this test, at the first stage means at the cell pressure stage, your drainage is allowed. That means your pore water pressure at this stage will be equals to zero. But in the second stage, that means at the deviator stress, your drainage is not allowed. That means your pore water pressure at a deviator stress stage will not be equals to zero. So this is the difference between these two tests. That means in the first type of test, at CD test, the drainage is allowed in both the stages, but in this consolidation undrained test, drainage is allowed in the first stage but not in the second stage. Okay, so when your drainage is allowed at a deviator stress, your effective major principal stress will be equals to sigma 1 minus UD. UD means your pore water pressure at a deviator stress. So similarly for the effective minor principal stress, it will be equals to sigma 3 minus UD. Okay, the third type of this stress is unconsolidation undrained test. It is also called as a UU test or quick test. Okay, in this, the stage 1, that is at cell pressure stage, your drainage is not allowed. It means your pore water pressure at the cell pressure stage is not equals to zero. And at the second stage means at the deviator stress stage, your drainage is also not allowed. That means your pore water pressure at the deviator stress stage is also not equals to zero. Okay, so this is the difference between these three type of a test. In the first type of test, drainage is not allowed at the cell pressure stage and as well as deviator stress stage. In the second type of test, the drainage is allowed in the first step and not in the second stage. Okay, and in this test, drainage is not allowed in the first stage and second stage also. It means your effective major principal stress will be equals to sigma 1 minus your pore water pressure at a cell pressure stage and at the deviator stress stage. It means your effective minor principal stress is equals to sigma 3 minus your pore water pressure at the cell pressure stage and deviator stress. I hope you have understood the difference between these type of test, and I hope you have understood all the topic of this lecture. And if you find this lecture useful, then please do like, share and subscribe. In the next lecture, we will see some more important topic of geotechnical engineering in a quick revision format. Then in the upcoming lectures, we will cover the numerical part of all these topic and we will see some topic in detail also. Okay, so if you haven't subscribed the channel, then please do subscribe it so that you will get the notification about the upcoming lectures, and you can give your feedback in the comment section and you can also ask your doubt in the comment section. Thank you for watching. Thank you.